1-300-56-4652. Okay, 1-300. Oh, I see that Norman is there. Well, we might as well get the idiots out of the way. Get it over and done with. Norman, good morning.
Hello, Lozzie, you dithering old fool, you feeble geriatric. Hey, you know who you remind me of? Joe Biden. You're both senile. You both need people to hold you up. You're pathetic, you really are. Mate, yesterday, you're the lifeline for the conspiracy theorists, aren't you? You let every dickhead come online and...
Well, I let you come on.
You let them spurt their crap and you just listen to it and you take it in. You give these people a lifeline of bloody somewhere to put their crap out and you just listen to it. Why don't you just cut them off and tell them to go to hell?
Why don't you mind your own damn business?
Oh, you're an idiot. Do you really need these people, do you? Because I suppose...
No, I don't know that I need them, but I'm not going to cut them off. It's my program. I'll do what I like, Norman, but don't tell me what to do.
You need these conspiracy theorists to ring up, don't you, eh? Or you need, Amy or something, little girls ringing up, you know, wanting you to give them a watch or something like that. Or you need your nurses or your truckies or your police.
Hey, I love them all, Norman. You're the one exception to the rule, but...
What about the nurses, the police and the ambulance people? You call them heroes. What a load of crap. They're doing their job.
That's right, and they're doing it in a very heroic way because the risks are very high at the moment.
No.
Anyway, you're never going to stop me crying the praises of the police and the ambulance people and the nurses because I'll go on doing it forever because I feel very strongly about it.
But they're not heroic. Don't crap.
Yes, they are.
Heroic?
Yes, they are. I mean, they're exposing themselves to danger, which is something I doubt very much you'd do, Norman.
No, don't.
I'd hate to have you next to me in the trenches. You would be a devout coward.
Hey, don't be a police officer, don't be an ambulance. If you're looking for bloody or praise or bow down to these people, they're heroes. They're doing their job. They're getting paid, aren't they? So they don't need any praise. Do your job and shut up.
Okay, in your mind, who does deserve praise? Why should we not praise our police who do wonderful work for us? I'll tell you what, the first time you're in trouble... And I don't know whether you've been in trouble before. I'm very surprised if you haven't. But the first time you're in trouble, who are you going to call for? A policeman. And when you're sick, who are you going to want? A doctor. And when the doctor comes and they move you to hospital, who are you going to want? A nurse. You're a moron, Norman. I mean, you're a really untidy individual. You've got a nasty mind. You're just you're a creepy little person.
Hey, they're doing their job.
That's right, they are doing their job, and thank God they are. And I'll tell you what, when the day comes that you fall over and break your elbow or something, the first person you're going to call for is a doctor and an ambulance and a hospital. And you'll need them all and you'll get them all because you live in the greatest country in the world. Now, why don't you just shut up?
It's like you, everybody coming out and praising you. Oh, John, you're doing such a wonderful job. John.
I'm doing my job. If it's a wonderful job, then I'm delighted. I'm simply doing my job.
That's why you want to hang around to over 70 years to beat the world Guinness Book of World Records, don't you, John, eh? You want the praise. You want the adulation. Look at me. Aren't I fantastic? Look, I'm going to be on a world record. I want to be here over 70 years.
Well, it would be nice. I think that would be nice. Is there anything wrong with me thinking that it'd be good to exceed 70 years as a broadcaster? I don't think there's anything wrong with that, is there?
Well, we're gonna last another 3 or 4 years of you. Oh, please.
You don't have to last any time with me at all, Norman.
Oh,
you can
really?
Put your head under a pillow and get somebody to sit on the pillow.
Oh, John, we're going to put up with you for another 3 or 4 years. You won't last, John. Come on.
Norman, that's wishful thinking that I won't last. You keep telling me I'm going to die, and you probably hope I am going to die because you really are just an unpleasant human being. In fact, it's very difficult to even call you human, Norman. That's how horrible I think you are.
I'm just waiting for the COVID to be over so you can get on a... This is probably the longest you've ever spent in Australia, is it? Hey, you want to get on a plane and leave...
Hey, are you mad? This is the longest I've ever spent in Australia. Are you mad?
They won't let you, John, with your pacemaker. Can you imagine? Oh, get on the train, put in the thing over you. Beep, 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 beep. Oh, what's that? Oh, it's John's pacemaker. No, I can't go on the plane, John. They don't want you dying on a plane.
I've been going on the plane Time and time again, I would have been around the world two or three times with a pacemaker.
Oh, they won't let you on anymore, John. Not when you get to your age, you dithering old fool, eh? Eh? You get on there with your little walking stick and shuffle on, or they push you. Oh, they probably push you on in a wheelchair, don't they, John?
God, you're nasty, Norman. Really, do you?
Norman,
just be quiet for a minute. Do you really get pleasure out of talking like this? Does it really give you pleasure to carry on this way?
Oh, John and his handlers coming on, and his nursemaid. Hey, how are you going, nurse?
You see, Norman, you can't even answer a question. In addition to everything else, you're a coward.
Why? What am I a coward for now, John? Tell me, why am I a coward?
Well, where could we find you if we wanted to say hello to you, Norman?
So I don't want to beat up on you, do I? Hey?
I beg your pardon?
Feeble old fool. Hey? You want me to beat up on you or something? Or am I trying to fight you to be not to be a coward or something?
I tell you what, if I saw you, I'd love to give you a kick in the ass.
Oh, you want to hit me with your walking stick, John? Hey?
No, I don't want to do that.
Hey, I bet you're missing your bloody restaurants, Johnny. Hey, hey, haven't
you? Yes, I am. I am missing. Oh. Listen, Norman, you have a problem. You don't understand that I don't mind the truth at all. The truth doesn't bother me at all. Yes, you're quite right. I am missing the restaurants because I love to go to restaurants and have a leisurely lunch or a quiet dinner, but not all the time, not every day. But yes, you're right. I'm missing the restaurants.
A leisurely lunch? You just want to get on the booze, hey?
I like having a drink with lunch. Listen, Norman, you're not going to bother me. If you think you're going to bother me, you're not going to bother me because...
motorised golf buggy?
I don't mind the... Yes, I do. If I drive... Yeah, I drive the golf buggy down there. Buggy. I originally did that when Caroline was alive because she was having some difficulty, but we're not going to go there.
Oh, your motorised golf buggy, John, eh?
That's what it is, you're quite right. And other people in the building use it as well. We use it for delivering groceries, we use it for all sorts of things. It's a handy little bit of gear that we've got.
Do they give you a bloody RBT on a golf buggy? Hey, I hope some points on it.
Oh, look, Norman, I'm tired of you. You're just nasty. You really are. You're just nasty. You're an unpleasant person. I'd love to know what you look like. What do you look like?
Oh, I'm an oil painting compared to you, John.
I'll bet you are an oil painting compared to me. I make... I have no illusions about my appearance at all. None.
I know you're a scary, scary creature, John. You really are. You're like the picture in the Dorian Gray movie, aren't you?
I wish I was, because...
Just a creature.
I wish up until the time he hit the painting or whatever he did, but...
Well, that's what I'm telling you about, you fool. You say you've got a mind like an elephant. What a load of crap. You can't remember what your last caller... Yesterday, all your callers. Oh, and they've mentioned something before.
Oh, look, Norman, enough is enough.
You couldn't remember, John. Your memory's going, isn't it?
Well, I don't need to have a memory because you obviously listen every day.
You need your nurse.
You listen every day, you poor, pathetic creature.
Hello, nurse.
You really are a poor, pathetic creature. If I could do something to help you, I would, but I think you're beyond help. You're just a nasty individual.
Okay, I'll get off, John, and let all the conspiracy theorists string up and tell you about COVID killing you and injecting you.
You're very good at changing the subject. I just said that you're a creepy little man. You're very unpleasant. You're very light on brains. You're not bad at putting your words together, but you haven't got any brains. You're plain, ordinary, stupid. You're unpleasant. You are exceedingly unpleasant, and you tell lies. And en masse, you tell lies. You're just a nasty bit of work.
Everybody up there knows, John. They just listen to you. They know you're...
Oh, look, I've had enough of you, Norman. Goodbye, Norman.
Bye, John.
Goodbye, Norman. What a horrible human being. I mean, he really is just a horrible, horrible human being. Imagine thinking that way. I can't believe it. I really can't believe that people want to think that way. Why does he listen to the program? Why doesn't he turn to another radio station? There are plenty of others he can listen to. He's just a creepy little fellow. That's all. I don't know that he's little. He may well be big. I don't know. I don't know what he looks like, and I don't want to know what he looks like. I'll tell you what, things aren't looking good for Victoria.